great and mighty King. Your praise I will sing. No one can do those great things that you do. The works of your mighty hand are perfect across the land. O great and mighty King, your praise I'll sing.
I will sing praise
with all I have.
How many is here today to hail King Jesus? How many is here today to hail Emmanuel? And how long will he reign? Forever, forevermore. And you can take that to heaven with you. Hallelujah to the Lamb. We welcome you today. I don't know about you, but I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. I mean, how many is here today that you was on his wake-up list? Hallelujah. That'll make you glad right then and there. So we welcome you today. We welcome those that are joining us by live stream as we celebrate Jesus' triumphant entry into Jerusalem, the last week of his life. Hallelujah to the Lamb. Those of you who are able, would you please stand with me for the reading of our scripture this morning? Our reading will come from the book of Hebrews, 4th chapter, starting at the 11th verse. Let us therefore be diligent to enter into that rest, lest anyone fall according to the same example of disobedience. For the word of God is living and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the division of soul and spirit, of joints and marrow, and is a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart. And there is no creature hidden from his sight, but all things are naked and open to the eyes of him to whom we must give account. Seeing then that we have a great high priest who has passed through the heavens, Jesus, the Son of God, let us hold fast our confession. For we do not have a high priest who cannot sympathize with our weaknesses, but was in all points tempted as we are, yet without sin. Let us therefore come boldly to the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need. The grass withers, the flower fades, but the word of our Lord will last forever. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, Father, we thank you, Lord. Our hearts are exploding today with gratitude, thanksgiving. We come before you, Heavenly Father, with no form of fashion. We just come to say thank you, because we are grateful. We come boldly to your throne of grace, where we can obtain mercy and find grace in a time of need, because we are a needy people. We need your love, we need your grace, we need your presence, because we're weak. But the scripture says that you understand that. And so for that, we say thank you. We come today, Heavenly Father, to turn our eyes towards Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith. We come today to turn our hearts towards Jesus, because he did for us what we could not do for ourselves. We come to offer ourselves as living sacrifices, holy and acceptable to him, because it is our reasonable service. And so we thank you, Father, for your word, which is powerful, sharper than any two-edged sword. And we pray, Heavenly Father, that you would touch our pastor today as he delivers that word to us, that it would be a blessing, Heavenly Father, that to us who are saints, that we would be edified to go just a little bit further on this Christian journey. Then it is our prayer, Heavenly Father, that someone would come down the aisle today asking what they might do to be saved. So we thank you, Heavenly Father, for this day. Let all of the songs and prayers rise to you as a sweet-smelling savor. We give you all the glory, honor, and majesty. It's in the wonderful name of Jesus Christ, our Lord, we pray. Amen, amen, and amen.
Oh, magnify the Lord, for he is worthy to be praised. We're going to ask you to sing along with us this morning as we lift up the God of our salvation.
Oh, magnify the Lord, for he Guests worshiping with us this morning, at this time, would you please rise and please remain standing until you've been properly acknowledged. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. As always, it's an honor as well as a privilege to welcome our guests. So on behalf of our entire Broadview family, we'd like to welcome you this morning to our Palms Sunday service. We hope from the time you entered our parking lot, when you walked through the doors and were greeted by a friendly smile, to where you are standing right now, that you've truly felt the presence of the Holy Spirit and know that you are welcome. If you are here and in need of a new church home, we hope by the end of this service, you need not look any further, for we would love to have you to join us in carrying out our mission is to make disciples for generations to come. More importantly, if you do not know Jesus as Lord and Savior of your life, please listen to the gospel message. And when the invitation is extended, know that we are praying that you will walk down these aisles and ask Jesus to come into your heart. Our ushers are passing out guest cards. Would you be so kind as to take it and fill it out and put it in the offering basket or give it to an usher at the end of the service? Once again, we want you to know, anytime our doors are open here at Broadview, you are always welcome. So sit back, relax, and enjoy your worshiping experience, and please come back and be with us again. You may now be seated. God bless you all.
friends, and guests. These are the announcements for Palm Sunday, March 24th, 2024. Join us on the journey to Resurrection Sunday. Special events are planned throughout Holy Week and concludes with two worship services on Resurrection Sunday at 7:30 and 11 a.m. We've saved a seat for you. Come celebrate the risen Savior with us. World Changers Youth Mission Trip. Feed the physical and spiritual needs of the community through building and painting projects July 15th through 20th in Chattanooga, Tennessee. Registration for youth 12 and over is open now through April 25th. Space is limited. A $75 deposit is required. Visit the missions table in the West Lobby or contact Deacon Travis Morris at tmorris@broadviewmbchurch.org for more information. All roads lead to serving. The Transportation Ministry is seeking safe and reliable drivers to transport our partners in ministry to and from worship service. To learn more about how you can serve, visit the Transportation Ministry table in the West Lobby immediately after service. Seasoned Saints Luncheon. Registration ends today. Stop by the Hospitality Ministry table outside room 158 in the West Lobby immediately following worship service to reserve your seat for a fun-filled weekend celebrating our seasoned saints. Evangelism and outreach. The missions ministry is seeking volunteers to assist in serving meals and sharing the gospel of Jesus Christ in partnership with Reborn Missions. That's on Saturday, April 13th from 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. Again, contact Deacon Travis Morris at tmorris@broadviewmbchurch.org for more information. Please pray for our youth, our church family, those grieving the loss of loved ones, those who are sick, shut in, recovering from illnesses, and please also remember to pray for one another. This concludes our verbal announcements. Please focus on the screen for another video announcements. Thank you for your attention.
There's a miracle in this room with my name on it. There's a healing in this room and it's here for me. Oh, there's a breakthrough in this room. It's got my name on it. Put your
I'm gonna Hallelujah. Has he done something for you? He's truly done something for me. And I'm so grateful that he has. Hallelujah. Whew. Nobody but Jesus. My name is Reginald Metcalf. I come to bring the offering appeal. Hallelujah. And it is offering time, amen. It's a pleasure to give to God, praise the Lord. Our scripture will be coming from 1 Chronicles chapter 29, verses 13 through 14. And the word says is thus. Now, our God, we give you thanks and praise your glorious name. But who am I and who are my people that we should be able to give as generously as this? Everything comes from you. Everything comes from you. And we have given you what only comes from our hands. Hallelujah. The word is already blessed. You know, it is so good to know that when we wake up in the morning and those when we go to work every day, everything that we do with our hands has been blessed by God. Amen? Now, how many of you are truly blessed by God? Come on now, you can do better than that. How many of you are truly blessed by God? Glory to God. Let us pray. Hallelujah. Most gracious God in heaven, we come boldly to the throne of grace and mercy. Not because we've been so righteous or so holy, but only because of your goodness, O God. Now, Lord, as the offering goes forth, Lord God, let it be used to glorify your kingdom, that souls may be saved, people may be touched, visions may be opened, eyes may see, Lord God. So, Father, we thank you, and we graciously praise your holy name, for you are the King of kings and Lord of lords. No other God but you, Lord God. So right now, God, we come to give thanks. Now bless this offering. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen and amen. There are numerous ways to give. As we see on our screen, you can give by text or by envelope or by online. The Lord is already blessed. Amen. God bless you. Thank you.
ought to give him some praise. You ought to offer him your best praise. I just feel a thank you, Jesus, in my spirit. A hallelujah. Glory to God. Lord, you're worthy. Lord, we bless you for who you are and for what you've done. We give you the glory and we offer praise. Search high and low, but you'll never find nobody like them. So you ought to offer praise. Sometimes if you can't say a word, you can just lift your hand and wave it from side to side. Oh, we offer praise. You ought to just think about what God has done for you, how he's how he's protected you and provided for you. You ought to offer praise. I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praises shall continually be in my mouth. We offer praise. The Lord has made. We will rejoice and we will be glad in it. Hallelujah. Let's thank our music ministry for blessing us on today. Haven't they blessed you and encouraged you today? Hallelujah. Grateful for our music ministry and our entire worship arts ministry, our dancers. Haven't they blessed us as well today? Amen. God is so, so good. Listen, it's Palm Sunday. You ought to at least one time in the sanctuary shout Hosanna, which means God save us. Hallelujah. Didn't he save us? I say, didn't he save us? Yeah. This is the beginning of this road to the resurrection. And grateful for your presence both here in the sanctuary and online. And we're looking for your virtual presence. Everybody shout virtual. This Wednesday at 7:15 p.m. Asking that you would join us on Facebook or YouTube as we host our virtual In His Footsteps Remembrance Service. We're going to be walking this week through the footsteps of Jesus, starting with Palm Sunday, the triumphant entry, all the way to Good Friday, and then on Easter Sunday, Resurrection Sunday, we will walk that road toward the resurrection. We'll be here Good Friday, which is this Friday at 7 p.m. Amen. I know that some of you all have Friday off. You probably have a whole lot of plans. But let me tell you, if you've got Friday off, you have a reason you've got Friday off. And that's because over 2,000 years ago, they took Jesus and they marched him up the Via Dolorosa. They marched him to the place of the skull and they put nails in his hands, spikes in his feet. They hung him high and blood came dripping down and he died. The world, they call it a holiday, but it's a reason we pause on this day. And if you do anything, I want to encourage you to be in this place on Friday night at 7. We have a special service that's been being prepared. It's titled Women at the Cross. And we're going to hear a first-person perspective of those who were at the feet of Jesus all the way up until his crucifixion. And we get to hear their testimonies. And following that, we will pause to remember and to reflect on his broken body and his shed blood as we partake in the Lord's Supper. you want to be here on Friday. And then Sunday, somebody shout Sunday. Sunday, it's the big day. No, it's not the Super Bowl. No, no, no. It's the big day. It's the day that changed everything. Because that's the day that the one whom we call Jesus was risen for our good. Amen. There will be two services on next Sunday. Two services next Sunday. One at 7:30 and then another at 11. You can choose which one you need to attend. But my prayer is that you would do your very best to not come alone. You ought to bring somebody with you to help celebrate our resurrected Lord and Savior. And I want to help you. Don't just bring a friend. Bring somebody who you believe the Lord has laid on your heart who needs a relationship with Jesus. Or someone who does not have a church home. They're out of the ark of safety. And so my prayer is that you would partner with me in that way. Will you do that, church? Oh, I don't believe you. Will you do that, church? Amen. Amen. God is so good. Well, if you have your Bibles, I want to invite your attention to the Gospel of John. The Gospel of John. Reading today from the New King James Version. Gospel of John, John chapter 12, verse 12. John chapter 12, verse 12. Amen. You find it, you'll find these words. The next day, a great multitude that had come to the feast, when they heard that Jesus was coming to Jerusalem, took branches of palm trees and went out to meet him and cried out, "Hosanna! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, the King of Israel." Then Jesus, when he had found a young donkey, sat on it, as it is written, "Fear not, daughter of Zion. Behold, your king is coming, sitting on a donkey's colt." His disciples did not understand these things at first, but when Jesus was glorified, then they remembered that these things were written about him and that they had done these things to him. Therefore, the people who were with him when he called Lazarus out of the tomb and raised him from the dead bore witness. Let the church just shout witness. For this reason, the people also met him because they heard that he had done this sign. The Pharisees therefore said among themselves, "You see that you are accomplishing nothing. Look, the world has gone after him." That's enough today. I want to share from this sermonic thought. Can I get a witness? Can I get a witness? You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Well, this was no ordinary day. But this was a day that would go down in history. People had come from miles around to this holy city called Jerusalem, and they were all there for one of three special pilgrimages or festivals. This one was called Passover. This festival in particular was one that helped the Jewish people remember their heritage, and more importantly, the miraculous acts of God. You may have heard why they've done this, why they've gathered for this time. You may have heard the story. It was a long, long time ago that Moses and the children of Israel, they were in bondage in Egypt, seeking deliverance from the hand of Pharaoh. And God sent 10 plagues to get Pharaoh's attention. It was that 10th and final plague. It was one that they never forgot what God had done for them. You see, God had told the children of Israel, he told them, you know, "I want you to put some blood on your doorpost. And when I come through the night, I'm gonna send a death angel. And when I see the blood covering the doorpost, I know that as a sign to pass over the house. Oh, but the houses that don't have the blood, the houses that are not covered with the blood, I have to stop in and handle some business. But what happened that day after God delivered them, after God set them free, after God made a way for them to be set free from bondage and to be delivered, it was that moment that they said, we can never forget what God has done for us. And so they began to gather with their families, gather with their familial unit, and they partook in an act of remembrance. They took some bread, they took some wine, and they paused to remember what God had done. The interesting thing is they kept this practice for nearly 1,500 years. All the way until the time of our text. And now God's people, 1,500 years later, are in this holy city. Something is different about this Passover. Something is unique about this Passover experience. Something is special about this Passover. Scholars suggest that in Jerusalem during this time, during the time of Passover, there would normally be about 50,000 people who would make the pilgrimage to celebrate this festival. But something is different. The text says that a great multitude had come to the feast when they heard that Jesus was coming to Jerusalem. My, I don't know about you, but this suggests to me, oh, that when Jesus is present, when Jesus is visible, when Jesus is at work, everything just can't stay the same. When Jesus is visible, when he's at work, when he's doing what he's doing, something begins to shift. Ordinary days can no longer be ordinary. The text actually suggests that there is a great multitude. This wasn't just a multitude. But this was an extraordinary day. In fact, Jesus' anticipated presence, scholars suggest that the great multitude had almost doubled. There is over 100,000 people in the city and in the surrounding areas because of Jesus. This is a lot of people. But the word has spread about this miracle working Jesus, one who the rumors were now spreading that he was the Messiah. It's when you look at this great multitude on Palm Sunday, you quickly begin to realize that it's more than just a large crowd. No. It's more than just a large assembly of people who are there for Passover, who have gathered for praise and to worship this man named Jesus. No, I want to suggest to you today, this ain't just a crowd, but these are witnesses. Let the church shout witnesses. They are there in this city on Palm Sunday to witness to the identity of Jesus. They're there to witness to the miracles of Jesus. And they are there to witness the mission and the purpose of Jesus come to pass. Yeah, they were there in that city called Jerusalem. They were in the crowd, but they're more than just crowd members. They are witnesses. I want to suggest to you first today that they were witnesses of his identity. Verse 12 tells us that the next day, a great multitude that had come to the feast, when they had heard that Jesus was coming to Jerusalem, they took branches of palm trees and went out to meet him and cried out, Hosanna! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, the King of Israel. Yeah, this was a crowd of people, but when you listen closely to what they are saying, what you quickly see is that they were witnessing to the word of God about the identity of the Messiah. This crowd has formed and gathered because they believe that there was something special about this man named Jesus. He was more than just a rabbi, more than a prophet, more than a miracle worker, more than a revolutionary. No, they believed that he was the Messiah. The crowd believed that this is the one who would save Israel. This is the one who would set Israel free. This is the one who would liberate Israel. This is the one who would set God's people free. I don't know about you, but I have to tell you, they knew something was up with the man. They knew something was different with the man. And that's why they recite the words from scripture found in Psalm 118, verse 25. A phrase in Aramaic, they said, Hosanna, but all it meant was, save us now. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. This is a traditional pilgrim's greeting. That whenever somebody would come into the city of Jerusalem, they would say, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. But they know it's something different about this Jesus. That's why they add this word, Hosanna. And they add another phrase to it as well. They don't just say, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, but they also say, the King of Israel. You got to get this. This is revolutionary. This is not normal. This is not everyday talk. No. They understood something was happening. Something was moving in the city. Something was at work, and there was something special about this man named Jesus. You see, this crowd, they believed he would be the King of Israel. They knew, hear me, who he was. They knew what he came to do. They just didn't know how he was going to do it. Say that again for somebody else. They knew who he was. They knew what he came to do, but they didn't know how he was going to do it. The good news for us today as we celebrate this Palm Sunday is we too know who he is. We too know what he came to do. But the good news about you and I, we live on the other side. We know how he did it. But yeah, these were witnesses to the messianic ministry and identity of Jesus. I wonder, do you know who he is? Have you tried him? Have you found out that he's your savior? He's your liberator, your deliverer, the one who can set the captives free, open blinded eyes. Do you know him? That's good news today. We know who he is. We know the identity of Jesus. But secondly, this crowd, they not only were a witness to the identity of Jesus, they were also a witness of his miracles. Part of the reason why they are in the city in grand numbers is because the rumor has gotten out. Did you hear what Jesus did with Lazarus? This is one of the last miracles that he performs before he makes his way to the cross. And when you look at verse number 17, you see that the people who were with him when he called Lazarus out of the tomb and raised him from the dead, they bore witness. Verse 18 says, for this reason, the people also met him because they had heard he had done this sign. You can't miss this in the text. This is in Jesus's 3 years of ministry. It's been a lot said about the man. He's healed the sick. He's made the blind to see. He's opened opened blinded eyes. He's made the lame to walk. He's turned water into wine. He's spoken to wind and waves, and they had to sit down. But this last miracle, this is something to talk about. This last miracle, it's something that puts Jesus in a category of his own. If you don't know the story, let me remind you. It was a few days earlier that Jesus got word to come to Mary and Martha's house because they were concerned about their brother who was sick. And they said, Jesus, we need to get you to the house. We've seen what you can do. And we need some help. We don't know what to do. But Jesus, he takes his time. He doesn't come right away, but eventually when he gets to the house, Brother Lazarus is dead. Rather than throwing a pity party, yes, he wept, but he pulled himself together. He said, show me the place where he's laid. And he walked over to the place where Lazarus was buried. And he simply said, Lazarus, come forth. Lazarus wasn't asleep. He had been to the funeral home. He had been embalmed. They had dressed him. They had casketed him. They had put him in the tomb. They had sealed. And all of a sudden, he just says, Lazarus, come forth. And a dead man started walking again. A dead man came alive again. I don't know about you, but this ain't just any miracle. This is something different that this man named Jesus had done, and the word got out. Did you hear what Jesus has done? You know that's Mary's baby. I was there when he turned that water into wine. I was there when he fed 5,000 with 2 fish and 5 loaves of bread. But we ain't never heard of nobody raising a dead man back to life. I'm trying to get you to see something. The word had gotten out. And I'm here to tell you that not only had the word gotten out, but people started believing in him. They say, if he can do that, surely he can do some more things. He might be who people say who he is. Surely something is different about this man. I don't know who I'm talking to today, but I need to tell you that when you've seen what Jesus can do, when you've seen living testimonies, breathing testimonies. You got to understand this. The people came from miles around just to see Lazarus. Is that him over there? You sure he was dead? People came from miles around, and when you come and you see a living, breathing, walking, talking miracle, you can't help but tell somebody about him. That's what happens here in this text. And I just wonder, as there are witnesses, are there any witnesses in this place who have seen what he can do? You've seen what he can do. You were sick, but he healed your body. You were broke, but he made a way. You were in depression, but God lifted your burdens. Is there anybody here who knows for themselves, I've seen Lazarus, and I might be him myself. He's raised me from the dead. I should be dead, but he reached down and he grabbed me. They saw the walking, talking miracle, and they couldn't keep it to themselves. And now the word has spread. It spread so much that the city is waiting on him. Is he here yet? I know he's gonna be, it's Passover. I'm sure he's gonna be there. Is that him? No, that ain't him. Is it that's him? They made preparations. They took off palm branches. They took off their cloaks, laid them on the ground. And they said, we know what to say. Hosanna. 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 There he is. Hosanna. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, the King of Israel. I can't help but put my spiritual imagination to work thinking about what happened that day. We know what the gospel writers have recorded, but I can't help but wonder, there's some other people in the crowd. That woman with the issue of blood. It's true, it's him. Oh, what he's done for me. Oh, what he's done for me. I believe Lazarus was in the crowd. Take a look at me now. I'm a walking, living, breathing miracle. There were some other people. I was there the day, oh, that he fed 5,000. It's the man. It's the man. Somebody was in the back singing, can't nobody do me like Jesus. Can't nobody do me like the. I wasn't there, but I just believe. It was a whole lot of shouting going on. And can't you see him? Not on a horse, but on a donkey. An animal is a symbol of peace. Riding that donkey. He's riding. And the people are rejoicing. It's a beautiful scene, ain't it? The branches are flying. The coats are being thrown down. People are coming from miles around just to join the parade. But wouldn't you know, in all of that grand cinematic joy and mayhem, if you will, there's some people on the side who have something else to say. There's some Pharisees who are confused about what's happening because their eyes were blind. Their hearts were hardened. And while there are witnesses to his identity, while there are witnesses to the miracles of Jesus, these Pharisees, they're struggling with his purpose. But I'm grateful for this crowd because they don't even realize it, but they too are witnesses to the purpose and the ministry of Jesus. While all of this joy and excitement is taking place, it's verse 19 that tells us that there is these Pharisees who said among themselves, they start talking to one another. They said, you see that you are accomplishing nothing. Look, the world has gone after him. Got to see this. While the people were waving palm branches, laying cloaks on the ground, while they're crying, Hosanna, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, the King of Israel. It's a whole lot of noise going on, but there's some haters on the sidelines. And what you don't realize is that while people had come to Bethany to see Lazarus a few days before, it's that word that got back to the Pharisees. And it was that that sealed the deal that it was time to put Jesus to death. They not only wanted to put Jesus to death, but they also wanted to put Lazarus to death. Because you don't leave no evidence around. These Pharisees, they started plotting when they got news that Jesus and Lazarus were up to no good. But it's amazing to me that what happens on Palm Sunday, we see that these Pharisees' plans, hear me, they are temporarily disrupted because the people in the crowd were witnesses of his identity, witnesses of his miracles, and they didn't even realize it, but they were witnesses of his purpose. They had no other choice but to shout Hosanna. They had no other choice but to give him his just due. And I'm trying to tell you, when you know he's a healer and he's healed your body, you can't silence a witness. When you know what God has done, when you've seen him be a way maker, when you've seen him do miracle after miracle, do the impossible, you can't put a muzzle on somebody who's seen a miracle. So hear me, verse 19. These Pharisees, their plans were temporarily disrupted because they didn't expect all of this hoopla about this man named Jesus. They didn't know that all this was going to happen. And so they said to themselves, everything we planning, it's accomplishing nothing because the world has gone after him. You got to see this. I want you to see this. This world, they all realize something's different about this man. We have to give him his due praise. We have to bless his name. We have to celebrate. We have to shout because we know there's something special about this man. What was a disappointment for the Pharisees? Yes, this parade, it threw a plan, a wrench in their plans. But can I tell you, it was God's plan all along. Even this parade is a fulfillment of God's plan. Why? Because as the Pharisees said, the world had gone after him. But can I tell you, this is the world he came for. The Pharisees are mad that the world has gone after him. But we know that's who we came for. It had to happen this way because this is who he came for. John helps us with this. The writer of this text, he helps us with this because it's John who records, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. If you stop there, you'll miss it. But God sent not his son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. You'll catch it in a second. The Pharisees were mad that the world had gone after him. But if I was there that day, I would say, that's what he was supposed to do. He came for the world. What the Pharisees were mad about all along, it was the plan all along. I'm through today, but I just wonder, can I get a witness? Somebody who will witness about his identity. You know that 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 he is the Messiah. You know he is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. You know that he is the King of Israel. But he's more than that. He's King of the whole world. I wonder, is there a witness today that can testify to his miraculous acts? You've read about it, but you've seen it for yourself. You heard that he could turn water into wine, but he's turned water in your life to wine. I wonder, is there anybody here who's been sick, but you've seen God made a way? You were broke, but you know he stepped in and he made your ends meet. You weren't sure how you were gonna pay your bills, but God made a way. I don't know, is there anybody here who's seen him do the miracles? And is there anybody here who can testify that you know what he came to do? You know that you are a witness. You're a witness, of his identity. You're a witness of his miraculous acts. And you are a witness because you know what he came to do. You know what he came to do and how he came to do it. Have I got a witness here? Yes. I wonder, is there anybody here who would have been in the crowd that day, who wouldn't have mind lifting up your hands, taking off your cloak, throwing it on the ground, waving a palm branch, and shouting, Hosanna! Hosanna in the highest. You would not have mind lifting up your voice, joining in the parade, and giving glory to God. I say, can I get a witness? Is there somebody here who know it was Palm Sunday that they shouted Hosanna, but it was Friday that they shouted crucify him? Somebody thought it was a plan of the Pharisees, but I told you, that's what he came to do. He came for the world so that he can seek and save that which is lost. They thought that they had taken his life, but how many people know that this shepherd, he laid down his life so he can save the whole world? Have I got a witness here? You ought to lift up your hands and testify about who he is. Look at somebody and tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, I know who he is. Say, neighbor, I know what he's done. And say, neighbor, I know what he came to do. You ought to lift up your hands on this Palm Sunday and join with the crowd, join with the witnesses, and give them glory, glory, glory. Can't nobody do me like Jesus. Can't nobody do me like the Lord. Ain't he all right? Ain't he all right? Ain't he all right? Ain't he all right? Shout yeah! Shout yeah! Hey, 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 yeah! I know who he is. I know who he is. If you got a personal relationship, walk across the aisle, find three people, and tell them, I know who he is. I know who he is. I know who he is. And I'll be a witness. I'll be a witness. I'll be a witness. I'll be a witness. I'll tell the world I know who he is. 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 Will you be a witness? Will you be a witness? Will you be a witness? Don't fool me. Will you be a witness? What about you right there? Will you be a witness? Will you tell somebody, I know the man from Galilee. He can heal the sin sick soul and set you free. Won't he do it? Won't he do it? Won't he do it? Yeah! Won't he do it? Everybody standing, everybody standing. God, we thank you. Because we know who you are.
Thank you, Lord.
We know what you've done. And we know why you came. You came for the world. Not just Jewish folks, but you came even for Gentiles. And that's us today. So, Lord, we tell you thank you. For who you are, what you've done, and the reason you came. Lord, today, our hearts are full. We're filled with praise and adoration because you didn't have to come. You did not have to do it. But you loved us enough to get on that donkey. To get on that donkey and ride down into the holy city. You even wrestled with what was to come in that Garden of Gethsemane. You said, Lord, if it be your will, let the cup pass from me. But you came to a place of sincere obedience, sacrificial obedience, because you told him, not my will, but thy will be done. And so we joined in with that cry. They didn't even know that you were using them to declare your glory. And I thank you that what you told the Pharisees, you told them, if the rocks, if you don't praise me, the rocks will praise me. Lord, my prayer today is that there might be somebody in this place who needs to be clear that they know who you are. They've heard about you, but they've yet to make a decision to move forward in their relationship with you. Your word is clear that if we confess with our mouth the Lord Jesus and believe that you raised him from the dead, we shall be saved. My prayer, Lord, is that you would move by your spirit in this place. Allow those who need to make a decision to come forward in just one moment. And Lord, there may be those who need a church family. Let them move forward in their relationship with you, knowing that they cannot do this by themselves, but they need someone to walk with them and encourage them and help them to be who you're calling them to be. For it all, Father, we tell you thank you.
Thank you.
It's in the name of Jesus we pray. All who agreed said amen.
Amen.
Before we go any further, asking that our servant leaders would make their way to the altar. And if there's somebody here today, you have not made a decision to put your hope, your faith, your trust in Jesus, this is a good day to give your life to Christ, to repent and turn from your sin, and let God get the glory. Bless you, my brother. Thank you, Lord. Is there another today? Bless you, bless you. Is there another? Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. If you got a reason to praise him and bless and magnify his name, you ought to sing it today. Thank. Bless you, my brother. Is there another today? Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Bless you, my sister. Is there another? I just want to. You ought to take a personal moment of worship and lift your hands and say, thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Make it personal today. Thank you, Lord. Thank. Is there another? Come on. Somebody in that balcony. Come on. Don't leave the same way that you came. Oh, I want to thank you, Lord. Thank you for who you are. Thank you for what you've done. And thank you for coming. For for the world. I just want to. Come on, we gonna keep singing and give you the glory. Why are you thanking him today? You saved my soul. That's why he came. Is there a witness in the sanctuary today that knows that he saved your soul? Come on. If you can't sing this today, you need to walk the aisle and give us your hand and give your life to Christ. Come on. I want everybody to be able to sing this today. You saved my soul. You saved my soul. Is there one? Come on. I just want to. Is there one? Come on. I want to thank you, Lord. Do me a favor. Ask your neighbor, do you need to make a decision for Christ? You've been so good. Is there one? Is there one? Come on. Don't leave the same way that you came. Oh, you've been so good. Just sang a verse that says, he saved my soul. Amen. My prayer is that no one would leave this place without the confidence that when you sing that, you know what you're talking about. And that you have blessed assurance that Jesus is yours and you are his. If you have never made a decision to put your trust in Jesus and say, Lord, I believe that you came to this earth. You were born in a manger. You walked this earth for 33 years. And one Friday, you died on a cross. They put you in a borrowed tomb. But on the third day, you rose again. And one day, you're coming back. If you have not made an official decision to believe in and on Jesus, I want you to not leave here without making that decision. If you need to make that decision, I want you to come forward even right now. You brought me out. He can bring you out of darkness into the marvelous light. Don't leave the same way that you came. He brought me out. I just want to thank you, Lord.
I just want to thank you, Lord.
I want to move on, but I just believe there's somebody else who needs to make a decision. I'm going to give you time. Bless you, my sister. Thank you, Lord. Is there another? Let's put our hands together for these who have come. Come on, you can do better than that. Hallelujah. Stretch your hand to these who have come, grateful for you yielding to the Spirit of God in your life. Father, we thank you for your sweet, sweet Spirit, which meets us at our point of need. And we know that you go before us, softening our heart and preparing us to yield to your will and to your way. I thank you for these who've come. They're coming in a variety of ways. Some are making a first-time decision. Some are deepening their decision by joining this church to grow in you. Some are restoring their membership. But whatever way they come, Lord, we give you praise, we give you glory. And we believe your word, which tells us you who began a good work in us is able to complete it. We thank you for your finishing power of your goodness, your grace, and your mercy. Bless them. Use them for your glory. It's in the strong name of Jesus we pray. All who agreed said amen. Amen. Come on, let's put our hands together. My brothers and my sisters, I want to celebrate what God is doing in your life. At this time, I'm going to ask that you would go to your right, your left, my right, right this way, and go with our membership intake team. They're going to give you some more information. Isn't God good? Oh, yes, 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 yes. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. We're going down from this place in just a moment. I want to tell you something. We're going to give the benediction, but I need you to stay and refrain from moving right after the benediction because I have something I have to tell you. Is that all right? All right. Let's thank our music ministry for blessing us in such a... Y'all look nice. You look real good. Thank you. Amen. Amen. Come on, let's stand as we prepare to depart from this place. I don't think they sung this on that day, but we can sing it for them. Praise God, from whom all blessings flow. Come on. Praise. Sing it like you believe it today. Praise him, all creatures. Here below. Praise him above. Heavenly hosts, heavenly hosts. Father, we thank you for what our eyes have seen and our ears have heard. Lord, we realize we don't just want to be in the crowd, but we want to be witnesses to your identity, to your miraculous works, and to the reason which you came. You came to seek and save the world. And today we're so glad that you did. Lord, as we prepare to leave this place, we know that we never leave your presence. Go with us, stand by us until we meet again. May the grace of God, the love of Jesus, and the sweet communion of his Holy Spirit rest, rule, and abide both now and forevermore. Let every person lift their voice and sing. Sing amen. Come on, let's sing it together, church. We're singing amen. Amen. Everybody, everybody, amen. God bless you. Before you leave, thank you for those who are watching and worshiping with us online.